in a competition where something's getting to the point that in your head you're like, ah, this is potentially dumb, and you need to make the decision that you're either going to do it or not do it.
In competition, you do it. It doesn't matter. In practice and training, that's when you don't do it. In practice, if you're starting to hurt and like legitimately hurt, not pain, you stop. But in competition, I mean, unless you're going to die, I'm gonna keep going. I think that's what a lot of people's issues is they start to overthink a workout. And it's like, it's just a workout, man. Just go out and do it, you know? And if you have to put the bar down for a second, put it down and then pick it right back up. I never walk away either. I never like, if I rest in something, I'm never gonna walk away from what I'm doing, because if you walk away, it's a little bit of a defeating posture. Like, that barbell just beat me. I'm never gonna let a barbell and weights beat me. I feel like actually the longer I rest in between sets, the more I start to psych myself out. And I've always said in my head, small goals equal big goals. And so my head, if we have, say you have like 30 reps to do, I never look at it as a 30. I'm like, I gotta go straight to 30. I look at it as fives. Like, I'm gonna do 5 reps and then I'm gonna see how I feel. And I'm gonna do 5 more. And then I get to 5 and I get like, okay, I can do 5 more. And I hit 10. And I hit 10, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do 5 more. Maybe at 15, I'm like, gosh, this is starting to hurt a little bit. I'm gonna change my goal to 3. And I'm gonna do 3. So I hit 3. And then all of a sudden, I'm at like 25. You know what I mean? And then it's like, and then it's always just one more. You can do one more. A good buddy of mine said when we were training together, he's like, it doesn't hurt that bad to run a little bit faster, does it? I'm like, no, you're right. You know, and that's always kind of stuck in my head. It's like, it doesn't hurt that much more to run just a little bit faster. My biggest weakness is strength. I know that I'm never gonna be the strongest guy on the field. I'm, you know, in Olympic weightlifting, there's weight classes for a reason. The biggest guys are gonna lift the biggest weights, and that's fine. This isn't Olympic weightlifting, this is CrossFit. And those workouts, I just have to try to maintain and be in the pack. You know, I can't drop to those 40th spots if I want to be on top of the podium. So that's why I do focus a lot on my strength now. And, you know, I think it's come a long way. I've attacked it to where I've just tried to hammer it. You know, there's little things that you can do to try to mentally break the person next to you as you're working out next to him. Even if maybe the match is close, if you mentally break him, like, it's, the match is over, and you can see it in a person. Say I see a guy break on a deadlift, I try to get 7 more reps in, you know, and show him that I'm not tired. And he's gonna look over and be like, gosh, he hasn't even broke yet. You know, like, that mentally plays with people. As terrible as it sounds, I definitely try to do that. You know, and I think most competitors do. When that 3-2-1 go comes out, I know I'm gonna do what I need to do.